Nitinol spring has a shape memory effect, meaning no matter how this spring is uncoiled at room temperature, it will return to its original shape when it's heated at about 100 degrees Celsius. This is really a fascinating shape memory effect. This alloy is made from nickel and titanium, and the shape memory effect of this alloy was discovered at the Naval Ordnance Laboratory at around the year 1961. Next, we are going to do the first experiment with this fascinating spring. Oh, I got this spring from Amazon, and this spring was manufactured by the KRL Research Labs. So we are going to test this spring and its shape memory effect. Okay, now we'll go ahead and start experiment number one. For this experiment, we need this nitinol spring. We need a heat gun. And also, every time I do experiments that relates with electric or heat, I always have my safety shut-off device. This is a remote control to shut off the wall outlet. So I'm gonna go ahead and uncoil the spring first. Okay, I'm gonna uncoil it. Okay. Let me uncoil it a lot more. Okay. I think that's what my camera can capture. All right. Okay, I'm gonna hold the other end with a plier. Okay, I'm gonna hold this end and I'm gonna start heating it from the other end. Let me bring my heat gun. Okay, now I'm gonna heat it. Watch closely as the spring starts to form the shape. All right, the spring memorized its original shape. So this is called the shape memory effect that nitinol alloy exhibits. Okay, let's wait till it cools down and then we'll go to the second experiment. Now for the second experiment, we will use electric current. Okay, the same thing, we're gonna uncoil the spring and then we will connect the two ends of this spring with a power supply, and I'm gonna pass very small current slowly and we're gonna observe the result. Okay, so nitinol alloy is made from titanium and nickel, so these two elements are transition metals. But the question is, what about the alloy? Does it conduct electricity? So first, let's do that simple experiment. I just paused the video and I connected these two ends with a multimeter. I have my multimeter here. I'm gonna put it on continuity and then let's see. Yes, so this alloy also conducts electricity. Okay, now we can go ahead and start experiment number two. For experiment number two, first we will uncoil this spring as we did it in experiment number one. Then I'll connect the two ends of this spring with my power supply and we will slowly increase the current to heat the coil. So I'm gonna go ahead and uncoil this spring. I'm gonna uncoil only the two ends. Okay. All right, so I have uncoiled the two ends of the spring. Now I'm gonna pause the video and I'm gonna connect the power supply and set it up and I will be back. Okay, I'm back. I connected the two ends of the spring with the power supply and I set it up for 2 volt and minimum current. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the power supply and slowly increase the current, and then we will observe the spring. Okay, power supply is on. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and increase the current, and then we will watch. Okay, the spring memorized its shape. I'm gonna go ahead and reduce the current slowly. Okay, and then shut off everything. Then close my power supply. As you can see it, the spring has returned to its original shape, and we call this shape memory effect of nitinol. This is the most impressive shape memory effect, meaning no matter how the spring is uncoiled at room temperature, it will return to its original shape when it's heated at about 100 degrees Celsius. So, what is the big deal about this alloy? It's because of its wide applications. This alloy has been applied for vibration damping, temperature control, medical devices, shape-changing arrests, linear actuators, and many more. Last but not least, I would like to thank KRL Research Lab for continuing the research and development of this fascinating alloy. This is all I have for today. If you like this video, give me thumbs up, like, and subscribe to my YouTube channel FWD Skill Don. Thank you and have a wonderful day.